So, lying. That's a. It's pretty interesting, hey? So, yeah, I'm the kind of person who, I'm like very, very kind of, maybe serious isn't the right word, but I'm like very, focused, I guess you could say, about honesty and truth. Like honesty and the truth is just really important to me because, I don't know, when other people lie, you know, it really sucks and it really makes it hard to tell what is true, especially gaslighting. Like, when people gaslight and try to give you false memories, that really sucks, because then you have to question reality, and you have to even just question, what is real, and, if you can trust your memories, and that's, like, a really scary idea to me. But even, you know, I think gaslighting is, like, a pretty big lie, but I think, small lies, even those, I'm pretty uncomfortable telling. Like, when I ask a friend to pick me up or something, I never say, I'm outside. When I'm actually inside getting dressed, I'll just say, like, I'm getting dressed now, but come over now and I'll come out. I'll be out by the time you're here or something, you know? Or if it's things like that, I really prefer not to tell small lies even. Even things people might not consider to be lies, like if someone's like, how's your day going? And let's say I'm having a crappy day, I feel really uncomfortable saying, I'm having a great day, or something, because, even things like that, some people might not consider that a lie, but I consider them lies, even though it's a small lie, and I personally don't feel comfortable really telling lies like that. The exception being, if we're playing a game, like Among Us or Werewolf, where it's about lying, and it's like a social deduction game where you're trying to, like, hide your role, I really like lying. In games like that, those are really fun, but, in real life, you know, in the real world, I try not to lie, especially because, if people ask follow-up questions, like, let's say you say, oh, I went and I did this or something, and then people ask you follow-up questions about what you did, then you have to add lies on top of lies, and you have to make up more lies on the spot to cover up the other lie, and it just becomes a giant tangled mess of, like, nonsense, and, you know, it's just really crappy, so, yeah, I just try to tell the truth. Anyways, because truth and honesty, they're such important, like, values to me, and they're so, like, core to, you know, what I believe in, stuff like that. When people call me a liar, where they say, you're lying, I take it really seriously. And I really, you know, it really, affects me. You know, a part of it, I guess, is just that I'm like, wow, you think I'm that bad of a person that you think I would lie about this? Or, like, when someone, like, accuses me of, like, gaslighting or something, I'm like, wow, you think I'm that bad of a person, you think I would try to gaslight you, or you think I would try to lie? Like, that, like, it's, like, astonishing to me, you know? I used to sort of have this mindset, I guess, or this sort of, way of doing things, where if someone called me a liar, or someone said I was lying, I would try really, really hard to prove them wrong, and I would try to show them evidence, or try to show them pictures, or try to get other witnesses to try to prove that I'm telling the truth. One time I told a friend about how, it was just this like dumb little story about how me and some friends, we went to this ramen restaurant and the waitresses were making some like very anime-esque sounds. And I told it to a friend and then they really didn't believe me. And I got kind of like upset about that. So I went and I like asked the other friends who went to that restaurant with me. I was like, you remember we went to that restaurant years ago, right? And I got them to vouch for me. And I, like, had multiple people. I talked to them. And then I, like, took screenshots of the messages and showed them to the person who didn't believe me. And I even had one of the people who was there talk to them in real life and say, I was like, yo, can you vouch for me? Can you, tell this person I'm telling the truth? And they're like, yeah. And they went to the person and, told them he's not lying, you know? So, that was sort of what I did for a while, where I was just like, you know, if someone doesn't believe me, I'll try everything in my power to prove I'm telling the truth. Yeah, and that was kind of how I dealt with it for a while. But as I kind of got older and I kind of got more mature, I started to just have this new mindset where I'm just like, hey, you know, if people don't believe me, then, you know, it doesn't matter, because I know in my heart and I know in reality that what I'm saying is true, and the story I'm telling or whatever, it did happen. You know, there was a time I was hanging with some friends, and we were like, you know, we're drinking some age-appropriate beverages, and I said I've drank before, and one of the guys was like, oh, nice lie, and he didn't believe me, and I really wanted to prove him wrong, but I didn't have any photos or anything of me drinking before, so I, you know, it just really upset me that he didn't believe me, and what I said wasn't even, like, an outlandish lie, or it wasn't even, if it was a lie, it wouldn't be, like, a crazy, like, lie, like, it's not like I was saying I freaking flew or something, I was just saying that I drank before, and he didn't believe me, which was really crappy. Yeah, but, you know, yeah, like I said, as I've got older, I've just kind of accepted that, you know, sometimes people won't believe you, and there's no way to prove you're telling the truth, so in cases like that, you know, you just gotta know in your heart and know in reality that you are not lying, and you know they're not gonna believe you, and that's okay. So nowadays I'll just say, hey, you know, if you don't want to believe me, you don't have to. You know, when people, well, let's say you tell a story about something cool you did or something you've done or something, and people don't believe you, it's not like retcon from Rick and Morty where reality just gets rewritten and the past is rewritten. You know, the thing you did still happened, it's just that people don't believe you, you know, and that's kind of just a freeing thought. Now, there are exceptions to this rule, like, let's say if everyone thinks that you committed a murder or something, or committed a crime, and then you go to jail for it, and you have to serve a prison sentence for that crime you didn't commit. Okay, in that case, it does matter that people don't believe you, and it, you know, even if you know in your heart you didn't commit the crime, but you still have to serve a prison sentence, then that really sucks. But, you know, in other cases where it's like a small, like, sort of a petty situation, like, you tell a story about something you did and people don't believe you, or something like that, you know, it's, you know, if people don't believe you, you know, it doesn't really matter, and you can just say, like, hey, you know, if you don't want to believe me, you don't have to, and then just drop it at that, you know. There was a video about Lego Ninjago that I saw, and the person said, oh, the animation in this show is really good, and they were talking about the season I worked on, and I said in the comments, oh, hey, I worked on Lego Ninjago, thanks for saying that, you know. And someone responded to my comment, and they said, I don't believe you. And I didn't even bother responding to that, because, like, you know, I could get into an argument in a YouTube comment with someone about whether or not I did it or not, but I know I did it. So, you know, if random people don't believe me, that's not gonna rewrite reality and change the past. Like, I did it whether people believe it or not, you know? And so that's just kind of the mindset I like to have moving forward with kind of everything. You know, unless it's, like, a serious, like, crime or something that people believe I did that I didn't do or something like that, you know? So, I hope this helps, or this was just relaxing to listen to. It was just sort of me going off the cuff, unscripted, very little editing. So, yeah, I hope you guys have a great day, and make sure to smash the dislike button, report the video, and add it to your watch later playlist.